This is a video on how to kill the fire-breathing monster things in forested giants. I'm also going to be killing all the enemies in this general area. This is actually how I kill them permanently. I do this 10 times in a row and get rid of them. So this is just going to show you the easiest way to do it. Actually, I may not be able to show you because it looks like all my enemies are gone. I think the fire-breathing things are still there, though. If the one by the door is not there, I'll show you what to do as far as where to stand and how to do it if he's not there. And he's not there. I don't know if these guys are probably gone too. Looks like it. Okay, anyway, the concept of this is when you come down here, you're going to open this door. While you're opening it, you cannot get hit by fire. Meaning, as long as you're in the process of opening the door, he can shoot at you all he wants, but he ain't going to burn you. Get in here, wait till the second time he shoots fire, and there should be two guys coming through the door. Don't mess with the chest until after you kill them. They will come at you. Now, once you've done that, you're going to come back towards the door after you've taken care of these two guys. Come out, lock onto him, like right here, lock onto him, fire at him, and then as he goes to fire, go back in here, because that'll keep you protected from his fire, and then just keep going back and forth. But anyway, the other one is still there because it killed me, so I am going to show you how to do the second one at the same time. As long as you have enough magic equipped, the main thing you're going to want to do to make the second one easy is make sure you have at least homing crystal soul mask and soul spears, and preferably soul geyser. Soul geyser will be your best friend on this guy. So what we're going to do is I'm going to go take the second guy out. I can do both of these at the same time without having to worry about it. Now, as far as the other two up top go, I will show you in a minute how to take out the one of the two without actually having to fight them head on. Basically, with just using the bonfire, you're gonna the one of the two that's in the room. You're going to, God, I hate this jump. My character just don't like to do it. Okay, first thing you're gonna want to do is make sure you're fully healed. Every little bit of life does count. Now, the next step is going to be to cast that so you're ready. Come over here and... oh, shit. Yeah, this fag is not playing around. He's tired of me. I'm not going to do the glitch I was going to, but that is the gist of it. But basically, that's how you're going to beat him. Normally, I can beat him, which is, he does different moves, and that's what makes it hard. When he comes at you and rushes you like that, you kind of really can't block him. And number two, I am wearing the Seldora armor. All my armor is because it increases your soul count. Therefore, I have little to no protection at all. I'm going to switch my ring up just in case. I can always do the glitch if I need to. I got to go repair those. But let's do this one more time. I could have just gone down that ladder and made things that much easier, but really don't matter. Okay. Now, for a warning, your crystal homing soul mass will not affect him. And I don't know why I'm opening that. I don't need to. Okay. Your crystal homing soul mask will not affect him that much, because it does not actually lock onto him unless he tries to attack you. If he tries to attack you, that's when it comes into effect, because it will zap him and it will take his life. So being prepared is the best step. I've actually killed him in 2 hits with the Soul Geyser, but you have to hit him directly head on and get lucky. That's not too common, you know, because normally he's gonna fuck you up pretty damn quick, especially wearing this armor. And God, I hate this damn jump. This is not the funnest jump, but, and you don't have to do it this way. You can actually come back down by the boss. There's a door, and once you beat the boss, you'll have the key, and you can actually take the second one and third and all them out using that door. Come on. There we go. Motherfuckers, gotta love him if you catch him in his G-Rod clutching his Glock. See, that's where your soul stuff will come in handy. Now, you are really going to want to take advantage of this part, because that's the best time to attack him, is when he's doing that, because that leaves him wide open. As long as you stay far enough back and you're locked onto him, he's screwed. He ain't going to touch you, and you can just fuck him up. There's this door here. This takes you over by the boss that's down the elevator. Now, you must kill the boss to get the key. I don't have the key because I haven't killed the boss yet. If you come up this way, you are probably going to ask to die, because there's this guy here, and then there's another one behind him. And this guy does the exact same thing as the first guy. He shoots fireballs at you nonstop. If you get close enough to him, he will use his tongue or ram you. But if you stay far enough back, he'll just shoot fireballs and annihilate you that way. Another thing I was going to show you, I already got it, but I'm going to show those of you that don't know how to do it, how to get a particular item over here, just in case, because I know some people don't know how, and most probably do. Anyone that played Dark Souls knows how to jump. They switched it on this to L3. However, if you go into your settings, you can actually set it back to circle, which is what I did. I really don't care for the L3 to be jump. I like actually having the circle as the jump, because that's what I'm used to, and that's just what I've been doing for years. Now, some of you may have noticed a body over here with an item on it, over there on that thing. The way you're going to get that is just to run and jump. It really doesn't take that much. See, I missed that time, but really not that hard. Okay, you kind of want to start running right about here. And you don't want to jump for the corner. That's where I am messing up. Normally I can make this jump every time. I'm just kind of tired right now or something. Niggas wanna die tonight, get high tonight. New niggas on the ride, even from these punk police. Oh my God, come on. Yeah, I think I'm just tired. That's why I couldn't do the other jump either. There are no enemies over here, because I've already killed them all completely, so I'm not worried. Just like the area that I was just in, I pretty much killed them all except for that second bug and third and fourth. My intentions were not actually to come do this Forest of Giants right now. I was actually working on Hopsman's Cops, or Huntsman's Cops or whatever it's called. But I wound up coming over here to get the key for my blacksmith so that I can fix my rings. Because without a blacksmith, I have no way to repair stuff. And all my rings are broke. Then again, I've leveled up quite a few times though, so it pays back. You know, I've been able to level up from 233 to 235, and that takes quite a bit of souls. And I don't know why this is not working. But as you can see, it really doesn't take much life, even if you miss. So, really don't make much of a difference. Okay, we're going to try a different method. I'm going to start right here. Whoa, shit. The reason I'm making these videos now, not later, is because most likely when I get done platinuming Dark Souls 2, I will probably not be playing it again. I really don't care for it. It's just not my type of game anymore. I just kind of lost interest in it. I mean, but I'm not going to go into why. I just don't really care for it anymore. See, but that's how you do it. And it's not easy, and especially if you're not good at jumping. Normally, I'm pretty damn good at it. I mean, I should be able to get it this time. Like I said, I'm just really tired right now. I'm dealing with a lot of shit today. Fake ass women.
You touch because of the weapons I clutch, and the niggas that I'm under is just too much. You have to imagine.
What in the fucking hell is going on? Now I'm starting to get pissed. It's like this character just don't want to fucking jump. That is not a hard jump. I mean, when I got the item, I did it on the first try. You know, so now it's pissing me off because I've done this numerous times. Now this is starting to irritate me because it's making me look like I'm a dumbass. Okay, run. Why in the hell is it going? Oh my god. I think part of it is this damn controller. My controller's kind of been fucked up lately. So, it's been doing its own damn thing. Like, sometimes I just can't fight or whatever and I get killed because of it. Anyway, that's how you do it. I'm about to just say fuck it because I've already got the item and I don't need it. And it's really not even worth doing. I mean, the item that's on there is junk, as far as I'm concerned anyway. I mean, my pyromancy glove is completely maxed. Everything's done, so I don't remember what it is, but it's not nothing major. It's nothing majorly important. It's like a soul of a lost undead and something stupid. That I'll never use, like a firebomb or some shit. Maybe it's a fire seed, I'm not sure. I doubt it's a fire seed, though. I think it's a fire bomb or... There we go. No, that just barely missed. Yeah, I figure I'll make some videos before I quit playing this. That way, they're out there. Yeah, it's gotten to a point where I honestly don't even really care to play this no more. I mean, if it wasn't for the damn trophies, I probably wouldn't even be on it. But because I'm a trophy hunter, I'm getting the trophies and that's it. I just really don't care for it. I mean, I wanted to play with someone, and they just kind of fucked me over, etc., wasted my time, so I'm just pretty much done with this shit. But I will make videos to show people how to get specific things before I quit playing it. I graduate with my bachelor's degree here in a couple months, and once I have that, I plan on becoming a game developer anyway, so I won't have time to be playing games like this, because I'll be making my own. Yeah, this is gonna get on my last nerve. Oh my god, are you fucking serious? This is another reason I hate this fucking game. It's not like Dark Souls at all. I'm sorry, but I should have made it by now. That jump is really not that hard. My controller's fucking up or something. I don't know what it is. Yeah, just fucking die. I really don't care. Man, this is so fucking stupid. I don't need those. I've got 99 of those in my box and almost 99 on me. You know, eventually I'm not even gonna be able to carry them, so I might as well get rid of some. I wonder if fucking Havel's shield is what's fucking me up. I should be able to do it this time. Oh my god! See, that was fucking it, but it didn't let me up there. I don't know what the hell it's doing. Other than getting on my last fucking nerve to the point where I'm about to just break the damn game. Fucking, I've thought about it several times, honestly. Because this is not Dark Souls. This is a wannabe version of Dark Souls. They totally fucked this shit. Setting the champion covenant right there in the first area of the game so that you just join it without even knowing what it does. That's what's fucked up. See, now I made it. Now that I'm not concentrating on it for some reason. But that's how you get that corpse and whatnot. So, I hope that helps you. Anyway, I'm off to Majula. This character is 235 soul level, and I've got over 10 million souls in soul memory. That'll probably double over the next couple weeks, because once this class finishes, I'll be spending the next month and a half on a break. So I'll be majorly increasing my level on this, that's for sure. Come on, bitch. Hurry up. And this annoys me, too. I mean, that's another thing that annoys me, is the fact that they should have just kept it the way it was on Dark Souls, where you could level up on the bonfire instead of having to come back to this stupid bitch just like you had to do on Demon Souls. I mean, it's stupid. You know, let's make you have to go all the way back to Majula and waste your time to go level up. That's fucking... To me, that's a waste of my time. I mean, you already got to deal with the loading screen. You have to deal with all the other problems of the damn game. You know, it's like you spend so much time doing everything that that's all time that's wasted. I mean, seriously. You know, now I freed my blacksmith. Now I can do what I need to do. And eventually I will probably make a video on how to do all the covenants, just so that it's there. Okay, come on, come on, come on. I really don't care, dude. I don't need any of his weapons. I need to repair. There. Anyway, for those of you that don't know, if you want to find the way of the Blue Covenant, it's right here. Come up and talk to this dude. Just keep talking to him until he offers you to join the Covenant. Just repeat his thing. So, you know, see, that's Way of the Blue. Abandon your Covenant and join Way of the Blue. I'm already a member of the Way of the Blue. I don't get why it's doing that, but okay. That's kind of dumb. You know, but just talk to this guy over and over, and he'll eventually give you the... Oh, wait. No, I was Blue Sentinel, apparently. Okay. That's right. I forgot. I'm not on my other account. My other account's a Way of the Blue. This account isn't... Or, well, it is now. Now, if you want to increase the game difficulty, come up here and join this covenant. You'll regret it. I mean, unless you really like really hard difficulty. Joining this covenant immediately increases the game. So if you're on new game, it makes the enemies as hard as new game plus. And it also removes the ability to be able to summon or be summoned. See, enter covenant, and this is the champion's covenant. Now, if you join that covenant, it will increase your difficulty of your game from new game to new game plus. Or if you're on new game plus, it'll increase it to new game plus plus. Etc. And it makes it so you cannot summon or be summoned, so just be cautious when you do it. The Rat King Covenant is down here. You need to fall down there and work your way down. I would recommend having a decent amount of life and the Cat Ring on, or having Fall Control. If you have Fall Control, you shouldn't have a problem with it. Later on in the game, when you find a ladder dude, you'll be able to use him to get ladders down, and that'll help too. So anyway, I hope this video helps you.